Good evening, teacher.
Hello, good evening. How are you doing?
Good, teacher.
Oh, nice. It's good to see you.
Me too, teacher.
Oh, nice. Thank you very much.
Hello, teacher.
Hello, how are you, Maria?
No he llegado todavía a casa, teacher.
Okay. So you will be as a listener.
Okay.
Okay, perfect. See you later.
See you later.
Okay. Hello, Adam.
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening. How's everything?
Excuse me?
How's everything? Okay, good. Bad. Fine.
Good.
Yes. Very how's good. Everything? How's everything is how are you, okay? How's everything? How are you doing? How are you? It's the same, okay? They are the same. Son of Isma, they are the same, okay?
Okay.
Okay, teacher.
Hello, Darwin. How are you doing? Good. We don't hear you very well, Darwin. I don't hear you very well. I don't hear you very well. No se te escucha muy bien. I don't hear you very well.
Very well.
Now I can hear you. Ahora sí. Now I can hear you better.
In this moment, I'm raining.
It's raining.
Yes.
Yes, I can hear that. Yeah.
Yes, it's raining.
Oh my God.
Yes, teacher.
It's raining in San Salvador.
Yes, teacher.
Oh my God.
Yes,
yeah.
Teacher.
Yeah, I see. I can hear that. Puedo escucharlo.
Yes.
I can hear it. Que les voy a apagar el micrófono a algunos por la interferencia, ¿ok? Cuando quieran participar, lo activan, por favor. So please, you turn it on, ¿ok? O de igual manera, si lo activan en la participación y luego lo desactivan rápidamente, ¿ok? Porque si está lloviendo, se va a escuchar bastante, bastante sonido. ¿Ok? So you do me that favor, please. Good evening. How are you doing?
Good evening.
Hello, good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening. How was your day? ¿Cómo estuvo su día? How was your day? Good, bad. How was your day? Really good.
Very tired.
Very tiring.
Very
oh
good.
My God. Very good. Excellent. Miguel says very tiring. Somebody said very good. Okay, nice. Days are like that. Sometimes days are good, but sometimes days are very tiring. Okay, so it's normal. So it's normal, Miguel.
Very hard.
Very hard, yes.
No,
yeah. No, days are hard sometimes. Okay, so let me pass the attendance quickly then. So please say present or here or I'm here. Okay, Ada Patricia.
Present, teacher.
All right, thank you. Okay, let me get another color. All right, Adriana?
Present.
Very good. Ana Michelle? Angela?
Present, teacher.
Azalia Melanie?
Present, teacher.
Very good. Darwin?
Sorry.
Thank you very much. Uh, Please, si me hacen el favor, solo activan en el momento y desactivan rápidamente, please, okay, please, all right? Just say present and then you deactivate, okay? Desactivan el micrófono rápido, okay? Please, do me that favor. Okay, let's carry on. Darwin?
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Flor?
Present, teacher.
Very good. Gloria? Excellent. Carla?
Present, teacher.
Excellent. Margarita?
Present.
Very good. Maria? She's driving, I think, right? She said.
Present, teacher.
Okay, Mayra? Mayra? Nelson? Nelson, not connected yet. Ophelia?
Here, teacher.
All right, Osmin?
I am here, teacher.
Great, Rafael? Okay, Rafael?
Present.
Great, Rosa? Sandra?
Present, teacher.
Yancy?
Present, teacher.
Good. Zulma?
Present.
And Miguel?
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you very much. All right, teacher, everyone.
Me, hello. Mayra.
Mayra, 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 let's see. Okay.
Thank teacher. You.
Yeah?
Teacher.
Me voy yeah. a tener que desconectar porque no es mi teléfono porque se me descargó. Ya voy a llegar y me voy a conectar.
Yeah, it's don't do it for long, okay? No, no, no se quede desconectada por okay. mucho tiempo, okay? Because you know the time, right? The okay. time counts in the attendance, okay? So okay. please do me that Thank favor. You. Okay, no problem. Teacher, all right, everyone.
Yeah? Yo me conecté cuando ya había mencionado mi nombre.
Okay, Michelle.
Yes.
Okay, very good. Just let me put it here. Okay, very good. Okay, so let's start then. And well, as you know, yesterday we started, which topic did we study yesterday? Do you remember? I forgot. I totally forgot. What topic did we study yesterday?
Should and shouldn't?
Exactly. We studied should and shouldn't. For what? For
a police companies?
For giving policies, right? For giving policies. That's right.
Advices?
Yes, for giving advice. What else?
Give suggestions.
Get suggestions and three purposes, okay? Advice and recommendations, exactly. So basically, we started should for three purposes, okay? Purpose number one, to give advice, okay? To give advice. Purpose number two, to give recommendations. And purpose number three, to make suggestions, okay? Very good. By the way, talking about advice is not possible to be used in plural, okay? You say advice, okay? Advices is not correct, okay? So you don't use advice in plural, okay? Because it's an uncountable noun. Es un nombre no contable. So you say advice, right? Only advice. Advices is incorrect, okay? Good. Now, yeah, basically we started should and should not or shouldn't to talk about policies, right? Policies at work, okay? Good. And what is a policy? What is a policy? Can you define, please? Can you define policy? Obligations, yeah. What else?
Rules.
Rules.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, they can be rules, that's right. Or disciplines, okay? Good, excellent, okay? That's great. Now listen, for today, we have the use of could for possibilities, okay? We have the use of could for possibilities, okay? But first, we have some discussion questions, okay? So I want you to take like 5 minutes, okay? 5 or 7 minutes approximately, okay? And I want you to answer these questions, okay? 3 questions. Question number one is, how often do you ask for permission, okay? It's you personally, right? How often? You can say maybe, I never ask for permission, or I sometimes ask for permission, or I always ask for permission, I don't know, okay? What is the procedure to request one permission in your workplace? And then you say, I call my boss, for example, okay? Or maybe you can say, I go to human resources and I complete a form, or I fill out a form, I don't know. In your company, what are some reasons for not getting a permission? Ah, okay. There are some reasons, right? Why you can get a permission. So what are some reasons for not getting a permission? Maybe you can say for visiting relatives or for going to the beach. I don't know. All right. Yeah. So you write the reasons. At least like 3 reasons, okay? 2 or 3 reasons. In question number 3, okay? So take 5 or 7 minutes to answer the questions on your notebook, okay?
Question three teacher?
Yeah.
Teacher.
Yeah.
Question three. Reason. ¿A qué se refiere? ¿Para no, que no me lo den o para yes. no ir a pedirlo?
No. I mean, let's say there are some reasons, right? Why you're not authorized to get a permission, okay? For example, you say, for going out with my family, right? So there's no permission, for example, okay? So it's one reason. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Or for celebrating a birthday of a coworker, for example, okay? In question number three, you can write like two or three reasons, okay? No more. It's okay. Two or three reasons are okay. In question number three. Okay, I'll give you two more minutes, okay, to finish. Two more minutes. Because I see some participants are still working, okay? So take two more minutes. Thank you. Okay. Okay, everybody. So basically we have three questions, right? So now listen. This time to discuss, okay, to discuss the questions, we will do it different, okay? This time you are not going to ask the questions to each participant, okay? So listen carefully, please. Listen carefully. You will go in groups, okay? And then one person is going to ask the question. One person of the group is going to ask the question, okay? Imagine, just imagine I work with Rosa, Mayra, and Carla. So Rosa, can you ask me the questions, please? Can you ask me question number one, please?
I don't know.
How often do you ask?
How often do you ask for permission?
And then I say, right? I almost never ask for permission, okay? And then Mayra can say, in my case, Mayra, right? Mayra is in my group, so Mayra can say, in my case, I sometimes ask for permission. And Mayra can ask Carla. Mayra le puede preguntar a Carla. And what about you, Carla? And what about you, Carla? The idea is to keep a conversation between everybody, okay? Or among everybody, yeah? So I repeat. So Rosa asked me the question and I say, I almost never ask for permission. And then Mayra says, in my case, I sometimes ask for permission. And Mayra asks Carla, what about you, Carla? And Carla says, well, I never ask for permission, okay? And then another person can ask the second question, okay? Imagine now Carla asks the second question. Carla, can you ask the second question, please? Carla?
Mayra, what is the procedure to request one?
I only send a message to my boss, notify my permission.
Okay, in my case, I say, right? I am a member of the group. Well, or in my company, I can say, in my company, I need to fill out a form and then I send it to the principal or I give it to the principal, okay? What about you, Rosa?
In my case, the procedure is that you have to fill a form in the internet. You have to print it and take to the human resources.
And take it to human resources. Now you ask Carla. And you, Carla?
And you, Carla, what about you?
In my case, I need only send a message by WhatsApp to my line manager and explain that I need a permission and only that. And okay. You,
Flo? No, okay, only the, remember, only the people in the group. Okay, now she included Flo, right?
Okay. Rosa.
Yeah, okay. Thank you, Carla, and thank you, Rosa and Mayra, okay? So listen, the idea is that you practice the same in the groups, okay? La idea es que practiquen de la misma manera en los grupos, okay? The idea is that you practice the same in the groups, okay? So you can use vocabulary like in my case, you can say in my case, in my company, you can say, all right, in my company, you can say, for example, there are a few reasons for the last question, or there are many reasons you can say for question number three, okay? Or there are only two reasons, yeah? Then you can say, what about you, Rosa? What about you, Flor? What about you, Ana Michelle? Okay, yeah? And maybe you can say, I think. Okay, so the idea is to use this vocabulary and to keep a conversation in the group, okay? Mantener una conversación en el grupo. A fluent conversation, okay? Do you have any question? No, it's clear?
No question.
So what vocabulary are you going to use? What vocabulary?
Teacher.
Yeah?
teacher, sería in my case.
Yes, you can say in my case. I never ask for permission.
Okay.
Yes, yes, that's right. Okay, very good. So then let's go to practice. Okay, I will give you like 3 or 4 minutes, okay? So in groups, let's go to practice
teacher.
Then. Do you have, yeah?
I need a question.
Okay. Make a screenshot. Háganle una captura. Make a screenshot.
Okay.
Ready? Yeah. Ready? Steady?
Yes.
Okay, let's go to practice. Let's go to practice then.
Thank
you. Okay, no problema.
Si quieren, comienzo. How often do you ask for permission, Darwin?
Okay, constant. What about you, Michelle?
In my case, I rarely ask for permission. And you, Flor?
I usually ask permission only when I have personal emergency or when my children are sick.
Okay.
In my case, I rarely ask for permission.
Question number 2, Michelle, what is the reason for?
Oh my God, why?
What about you, Ada?
I'm rarely, only when I'm not feeling well.
Okay.
Rafael, creo que es, o no estaba.
No está.
En you, Azalia.
In your work. Repeat, please, Ada.
How often do you ask for permission?
Miguel, creo que es la misma pregunta para todos, ¿verdad?
In occasion, in family or health emergency, be controlling the hospital.
Okay.
Hello. Maybe you can say when I have an appointment in the hospital. When I have an appointment in the hospital. An appointment. You say appointment. Una cita. When I have an appointment in the hospital. Appointment.
Okay, thank you.
By control.
Okay. Or when I have control, you can say control.
Okay.
I never visited the hospital.
Thanks, God.
Yo puedo decir is.
Ajá.
Azalia. What are some reasons for not getting permission, Astalia?
Number three.
Two.
What is the process?
Okay.
How the permission slip. Number two, ask the boss.
Repeat, Osmin.
Okay, number one.
Understand.
Okay, number one, fill out the permission slip. Number two, ask the boss. This is in my case.
Okay. Osmin, continue. Yeah. What about a who? Who, me, Rosa, Ophelia?
What about you? How often do you ask for permission?
Who?
Who? ¿Quién, Osmin?
Rose.
Ah, me.
Okay, yeah, for you.
Okay, sorry. Okay.
Okay, I repeat. How often do you ask for permission?
No, it's the second question. That question I asked, I answered.
And number two.
Question number two.
Okay, what is the procedure? To request when?
Procedure.
Exactly. Thank you.
Procedure. Yeah. Great. What is Thank the procedure? You.
What is the procedure to request one? Yeah.
My boss doesn't grant permits. He exchanged them from annual vacation. Or compensatory.
Time compensatory. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. What is the pressure to request one, Angela?
Tenemos otra compañerita, María Estela.
Okay.
Procedure. Procedures. What is the procedure to request one? Okay. What is the procedure to request one? Okay. Procedure. Yeah. What is the procedure to request one?
The procedure to request one.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, teacher.
Okay.
Thank you, teacher.
Okay.
Maria is the question.
Okay.
Hi, Maria Estela. What is the procedure to request one?
The microphone. Your microphone is off. Maria. Your microphone is off. No le escuchamos.
Hello.
Sí.
Hello. Vengo ingresando, no sé en qué están ahorita.
Ah, okay.
Mejor los escucho para agarrarles.
Ok.
¿En qué están?
We are answer three questions. One question.
The second question. Mayra, the second question for Jancy.
Jancy, what is the procedure to request one?
Okay, fill out a permission form and give it to the boss for
Authorization.
And then present into the human resource department.
Okay.
Margarita, what are some reasons for not getting a permission?
Well, going to a trip with friends, staying to sleep at home, and going to drink beers or alcoholic beverage with someone else. Okay.
You can only go to drink alcoholic beverages alone, right? With someone is not possible, but alone, yes.
Someone. alone it is. ¿Cómo es permitido?
It's allowed. Allowed.
It's allowed.
Allowed.
It's allowed.
Allowed. Yeah. Okay.
Okay. But, Jancy, in your company, how often do you ask for permission?
I don't ask permission often. Only when I am sick. Maida.
In my case, I'm sorry. In my case, I hardly ever ask for permission. I only need a permission when I am sick.
Is this same with Jancy? In my case, I ask for permission when I need free time. For example, I do important things or some things about my nephews, concert or shows. So I ask for permissions for my boss.
Okay.
At my boss.
What is the procedure?
Well, when you need a day off, you should 2 days before the day have to give a boss a memorandum with details of why I need a day off.
My case? Usually I send a message or WhatsApp. I send a WhatsApp to my boss, notify the situation, and always he say, okay, no problem. Take the day.
Okay. Jancy, what are some reasons for not getting a permission?
When you excel your day off,
exceed.
Uh-huh.
When you exceed. When you exceed. Yeah.
Exceed.
Yeah.
Exceed. Your day off.
Yes.
Okay.
You say to my boss, Margarita, to my boss, ask a permission to my boss, okay? For Margarita. You say to my boss.
To my boss.
Yes.
Yo decía a boss.
No, to my,
To my boss.
To my boss, yeah.
To my boss, okay. Sería, you should have to give to boss, así.
Give it. Give the permission to your boss. Or to my boss in this case. Okay?
Okay.
I should give the permission to my boss. Okay.
My boss. Okay. Give the permission to my boss. Acción de personal, ¿cómo se dice, teacher?
Sorry?
Acción de personal, yo por eso puse memorándum, pero es acción de personal.
What do you mean? Like, what do you want to say? ¿Cuál es acción de personal?
La acción de personal es...
como un formulario.
Es como un formulario donde uno pone sus días libres o sus días de vacación cuando lo va a pedir.
Ah, you can say form. It's a form in the end.
Form.
Okay, teacher, okay.
Which spider of you, coop or excavation?
Oh, really? Uh-huh. Okay, Margarita, you say form, okay, for acción de personal, but you need to explain, okay? You can say, I need to complete a form specifying the days, for example, okay? Specifying the days, all right? So you can say that, okay? Very good. Okay, everybody. So I'm not going to ask you to share with the class because I know you practice, okay? The most important is that you practice. I just have a question, like in general, okay? This question is for everybody. For someone who wants to answer this question, okay? How many personal permissions do you have available a year? In 1 year, how many permissions or personal permissions do you have available, disponibles? How many? 1, 2, Rafael?
In my case, we have 40 hours.
40 hours, and that's how many days exactly?
5 days.
5 days, okay. So basically you have 5 days, like according to the law. What about the rest? Thank you, Rafael, thank you very much. What about the rest?
In my case, we do not have a limit of days.
Okay, very good, that's interesting, nice. So basically, according to the law, you have 5 days, right? According to the law, right? But remember that policies in different companies are different, okay? For
teacher,
permissions.
Yeah. In my case, yes, Margarita? I take my vacation days.
Okay, so how many days?
Like 15 days.
Okay, you take 15 days, but apart...
O sea, nosotros no tenemos días libres, sino que nuestros días de vacación toman.
Oh,
si
I see.
Si yo pido un día, me quitan un día de vacación.
I understand, all right? So you can take...
Pero la permission is different the vacation.
For example, in my case, no.
That's why I said, okay, so we have... According to different companies, we have different, they have different policies, okay? They have different policies. Yeah, they vary a lot. Very good. So it's good to know.
Company or boss.
Yeah.
Company or boss.
Mm-hmm.
Because this rule is from my boss, not is the company.
I wanted to say that, but I didn't say it. I said companies in general, Miguel. But I know sometimes the problem is not the company, right?
People.
It depends on the boss. That's right. Okay.
But sometimes the companies, for example, when somebody get married, they have three free days. When someone of your parents die, you have 3 days too.
I think that's in general, Rosa, that's what the law says, right? That's what the law says, okay, in general, okay? Yeah. But the problem is that for some companies, they don't follow the law, right? That's the problem, okay? Alguna compañía no tiene la ley. That's the problem, okay? Yeah, but that's according to the law, okay? 3 days when you get married, I think. 3 days if somebody, a very close relative dies, you take 3 days, okay? Yes, that's right. And the law says that you have five personal permissions a year. Like that, I mean, those are like...
Really?
Yeah,
really?
Yes, yeah, that's what I know, all right?
Yes, la ley, yes.
That's according to the law.
Del código del trabajo.
Yes.
Three.
But as I said, As I said, right?
Bernardo said that I have quite
a... No, please don't mention my name, please. Don't mention my name. I could get in trouble.
Okay.
All right, so thank you very much for sharing your answers, and thank you very much for discussing the answers of the questions, okay? Now, let's go to the conversation. We always have a conversation, right? So look, I want you to, hold on a second. I want you to take like 2 minutes, okay, and read the conversation. And in 2 minutes, I will ask you some questions about the conversation, okay? So please take some time and check the conversation. And afterwards, I have some questions for you. Read for comprehension, please.
Yes, teacher.
Oh. This is on page number 41. 41.
No la tengo, no me la tiro cuando mandé a imprimir el libro.
Oh my God. You can look at the screen here, no problem, okay? I will leave it there for you.
Yes, hasta la 40.
Oh my God. Okay, so listen, I have some questions about the conversation. If you have the answer, if you or in case you have the answer, go to reactions and raise your hand, okay? I repeat, in case you have the answers, go to reactions and raise your hand, okay? The first person to raise the hand will have the opportunity to answer the question, okay? Yeah, very good. Now let's go. Don't give the answer, okay? Just wait. When I say, okay, Ana Michelle, so Ana Michelle can answer, okay? Don't raise your hand and give the answer, okay? Hold on. Raise your hand and then I will assign the person to give the answer, okay? Okay, now let's go again to the conversation. So question number one. Well, first, in the conversation, we have 3 people, right? We have Hank, we have Julie, and we have Betty, all right? First, let's have an inference question. Let's have an inference question. So question number one is, what is Hank's position in the company according to your opinion? What do you think? What is Hank's position in the company according to the conversation? Traten de inferir, try to infer. Okay, Maria Estela? What do you think?
He is the Julie's Betty's boss.
All right. He is Julie and Betty's boss. All right. Thank you very much, Maria. Rosa, what do you think?
Maybe he's colleague.
Maybe he's a colleague, right? Because I don't see like superiority, okay? Yeah, maybe he's a colleague, all right? Remember, it's about inferring, okay? It's about inferring the position. Okay, secretary. Let's see. Maybe, no, Hank. Hank? It's a secretary? Hank. Not Julie and Betty, Hank.
Ah.
All right, now let's see. Question number... Maybe he's a boss, all right? Yeah.
Boss?
Gerent. Ingerent in company.
Sorry?
Ingerent in company.
Oh.
Ah, the manager of the company.
Manager, administrative manager.
Yeah, maybe he's an administrative manager, all right? We don't know, right? We don't know. That's why I say infer the position, okay? Just try to infer because we don't have the information, okay? So this is an inference question. Yeah, you think that? I think that
they are co-workers.
Yes, I think the same. I think the same. I think they are co-workers, okay? Good. But we don't have the information. We don't know, right? But it's an inference question. Let's see question number two. Who has a problem? Who has a problem? Okay, let's listen to... Okay, oh, wait. Let's listen to Michelle.
Betty.
Betty has a problem. Betty has a problem. Okay, very good. Thank you, Anna Michelle. Next question. Lower the hand, please. Bajemos la mano. Lower the hand, please. So I see. Maria, can you lower the hand, please? Podemos bajar la mano, please. Can you lower the hand, please? Okay, thank you very much. Okay, next question. What is Betty's problem? What is Betty's problem? Okay, let's listen to Angela. What is Betty's problem, Angela?
His problem, Betty, is your mother is sick.
My mother?
Her mother.
Ah, her mother. Ah, okay, thank you very much. I was like, oh my God. Her mother. Yeah, it's okay.
Her mother.
Her mother is sick. Thank you, Angela. Thank you very much. Next question, okay? Next question. Let me see. What is the process or the procedure to ask for permission in this company? What is the procedure to ask for permission in this company, Adriana? The microphone, Adriana, the microphone.
The request? The form in the human resource department.
Ah, yes. Okay, the procedure is to request a form in human resources, okay? To go to human resources and to request a form, okay? Yeah. Okay, thank you very much. All right. Now, is it necessary for Betty to mention the reason for the permission?
Mention the reason for the permission.
Is it important to mention the reason? Yes, Azalea Melanie?
Yes, absolutely.
Yes, absolutely. Yes, absolutely. All right, thank you very much. Now please, listen to the pronunciation of the conversation, okay? Listen carefully. Listen carefully to the pronunciation of the conversation, okay? All right, listen carefully. Let's start with Hank. Good morning, ladies. How are you doing today? Hello, Hank. I am okay, but Betty is not. Really? What's wrong, Betty? Well, my mother is sick, and my sister can go see her tomorrow. I am sorry to hear that. You could ask for permission. He is right. You could go to HR department and request a form. Could I mention the reason for the permission? Yes, absolutely. Listen again. Good morning, ladies. How are you doing today? Hello, Hank. I am okay, but Betty is not. Really? What's wrong, Betty? Well, my mother is sick, and my sister can go see her tomorrow. I am sorry to hear that. You could ask for permission. He is right. You could go to HR department and request a form. Could I mention the reason for the permission? Yes, absolutely. All right. Now let's do it again, but this time repeat. But repeat with the microphone off, okay? Repeat with the microphone off. And I want to see everyone repeating, okay? So please turn on your cameras. Enciendan sus cámaras. Turn on your cameras. I want to see you repeating, okay? I see some cameras are off. All right, let's repeat. Good morning, ladies. How are you doing today? Hello, Hank. I am okay, but Betty is not. Really? What's wrong, Betty? In this case, wrong, okay, the letter W is mute, okay? You don't pronounce the letter W. You only say wrong, wrong, okay? What's wrong, Betty? Wrong, okay? You don't say wrong, no, right? Wrong, that's it, okay? What's wrong, Betty? So the letter W is mute. Let's continue. Well, my mother is sick and my sister can go see her tomorrow. I am sorry to hear that. You could ask for permission. He is right. You could go to HR department and request a form. Request. Request. Could I mention the reason for the permission? Yes, absolutely. 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 Okay, let's listen to Darwin and Nelson. And Ophelia. All right, let's listen. I think it's better if we listen to Darwin, Ophelia, and Sandra, okay? Darwin, Ophelia, and Sandra. Okay. Darwin, you are Hank. Ophelia, you are Julie. And Sandra, you are Betty. Sandra, okay. You are Betty, okay? Let's start, Darwin.
Okay. Good morning, ladies. How are you doing today?
Hello, I'm okay, very, but very is not.
Really? Sandra, hello, is what? Sorry, Darwin.
Really? What's wrong, Barry?
Well, my mother is sick and my sister can go see her tomorrow.
I'm sorry to have that. You could ask for permission?
This is spring. You call. I go to hiring department and records are for. I mention the reason for the permission.
Yes, absolutely.
I think this part is for Julie, right? For Julie.
Okay.
You say he is right. Okay, and this part is for Betty, I think. This part I think is for Betty, right? Yeah. There is a mistake. It says Julie, but I think it's for Betty, okay? And this part is for Julie. Okay. Okay, thank you very much, Darwin, Ophelia, and Sandra. All right, now let's listen to Nelson, Mayra, and Jancy. Nelson, Hank, Mayra, Julie, and Jancy Betty. Let's listen, please.
Okay. Good morning, ladies. How are you doing today?
Hello, Hank. I'm okay, but Betty is not.
Really? What's wrong, Betty?
Well, my mother is sick and my sister
can see her tomorrow.
I am sorry to hear that. You could ask for permission?
He's right. You could go to a human resources department and request a form.
Betty, could I mention?
Could I mention the reason for the permission?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay, thank you very much, Mayra, Jancy, and Nelson, right? Thank you very much. Here, okay, the pronunciation for this one is here, okay? I am sorry to hear. I am sorry to hear that, okay? Here. I am sorry to hear that, okay? Here, yeah?
Here.
Thank you. Here, here. Okay, no problem. Very good. Now let's listen to another group of three, all right? So for this one, we are going to have, let me see here, Miguel. Okay, because I can see Rafa is there, but his camera is not on, okay? So let's listen to Rafael, Hank, Maria, Julie, and Adriana, Betty, all right?
Okay.
Okay, Miguel. Hank.
Hank.
Oh, okay, teacher. Say it's Rafael, okay. Good morning, ladies. How are you doing today?
Hello, Ham. I am okay, but Betty is not.
Really? What's wrong, Betty?
Well, my mother is sick, and my sister can go see her tomorrow.
I'm sorry to hear that. You could ask for permission.
He's right. You could go to HR department and request support.
Could I mention the reason for permission? For the permission?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay, thank you very much. That's excellent. All right, everyone. Now listen, I want to mention something very important about intonation, okay? Pay attention to this carefully. Listen. When you have a close question, intonation is like going up, okay? I repeat, when you have a close question, the intonation is like going up, okay? For example, could I request for a permission? It's like, could I request for a permission? The intonation is going up, okay? And when you have a sentence, not a question, the intonation is flat. Okay, the intonation is flat. For example, it's not the same to say, could I ask for a permission? Than saying, I could ask for a permission. It's like flat, okay? So that is the difference between these two questions, yeah? For example, I could say using do, right? Like, do you go to work early? Do you go to work early? It's like you go up, okay? The intonation goes up. And it's different if I say, I go to work early. So the intonation is flat. La intonación es como plana, okay? It's kind of flat, okay? So that is the difference between a closed question and a sentence in pronunciation, okay? That's very important. But listen, but when you have an open question, the pronunciation is different. It's like, you go down, okay? When you have an open question, the intonation goes down, la entonación va hacia abajo. For example, when you say, what's your name? You don't say, what's your name? All right, you say, what's your name? So you are like going down, okay? Or when you say, where do you live? You don't say, where do you live? All right, where do you live? So it's like goes down, yeah? Or who do you practice English with? Who do you practice English with? So the intonation is going down. Okay, this is for open questions, okay? Yeah, so do you have any question about this? This is important. Do you have any question about this? No, it's clear.
Teacher, yeah? not understand the difference in the question one and the last question.
In question one and question?
The last question, so the intonation is up and the intonation is down.
For example, I will do it with the same example. Imagine I say, Do, okay, using do. Do you attend clients? Do you attend clients? So you are like going up. La entonación va subiendo. Do you attend clients? But if I say, how many clients do you attend? You don't say, how many clients do you attend? No, right? You say, how many clients do you attend? Va hacia abajo. Okay, it's going down. Yeah? It's like when we use WH words. Cuando usamos palabras con WH para hacer preguntas abiertas, la entonación va hacia abajo, okay? Intonation goes down, yeah?
Okay, teacher, thank
you. All right. Yes?
In the conversation...
yeah, in the conversation?
Que estamos practicando, ajá. Podría como... darnos el ejemplo de esa conversión, eso, justo. De lo que está hablando, de la entonación.
For example, this.
Las cuestiones. Ajá.
Say, how are you doing today? You don't say, how are you doing today? No, right? How are you doing today? It's like going down. Van hacia abajo. Okay? And then we have this one. What's wrong, Betty? What's wrong, Betty? So you don't say, what's wrong, Betty? No, right? What's wrong, Betty? Okay, so it's going down. Va hacia abajo. And then, in a sentence, en una oración, here. My sister can't go see her tomorrow. It's like flat. Aquí es plana, porque es una oración. My sister can't go see her tomorrow. Okay, good. And then this. Ah, aquí tenemos una pregunta cerrada. We have a closed question. So, esta va hacia arriba. Could I mention the reason for the permission? Yeah, can you see it? ¿Pueden notarlo? Could I mention the reason for the permission?
Yes, teacher.
So, it goes up. Va hacia arriba. It goes up, okay? Ya, yeah. Ahora sí.
Oh, sí, o sea, en las de donde las cuestiones de lo que llevan doble.
PH.
W. Ajá.
Yes.
Esas sí van a ser así.
Hacia abajo.
Ah, no, para abajo, dijo.
Hacia abajo. Yeah. Okay. They go down. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay,
it's
perfect.
New.
Yeah, that's important in pronunciation, by the way. Okay, that's very important. Very good. So we discussed some questions, so we don't have to discuss that. Oh, let me pass the attendance quickly. Voy a pasar asistencia rápido before I forget. Yes. Since I'm a little forgetful, I prefer to pass the attendance right now. Okay. Ada Patricia?
Present.
Adriana?
Present.
Ana Michelle?
Present.
Angela?
Present, teacher.
Azalia Melanie? Azalia Melanie.
Teacher.
Okay, thank you. Darwin?
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Flor?
Present.
Very good. Gloria?
Here.
Carla?
Present.
Margarita?
Present.
Maria?
Present.
Mayra?
Present.
Nelson?
Present.
Ofelia?
Here, teacher.
Osmin?
I'm here, teacher.
Rafael?
Present.
Very good. Ready to work, Rafael? Yes. Ready to work?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. Yes. Rosa?
Present.
Sandra?
Present, teacher.
Jancy?
Present.
Zulma?
Here.
And Miguel?
Present, teacher.
All right, thank you very much. Okay, that's very good. Okay, now, listen. So in this moment, we have the main topic. And the main topic for today is the use of could. Could, we use could for possibilities, okay? And let me show you some examples here, okay? So when you want to give like or speak about possibilities, you use could, okay? Now check this out. Check this out, okay? I have the first example, okay? So the structure is, subject, here is, aquí sería could, no should, okay? There is a mistake, hay un error ahí. So subject plus could, verb in the base form and complement, okay? So let's see one example. You could request a day off, complement, okay? You could request a day off. How do you say this sentence in Spanish?
Debería.
No.
Podría.
Podría. Podrías, in this case. Deberías is a suggestion or a recommendation, right? In this case is podrías, okay? You could is tú podrías pedir un día libre, okay? You could request a day off. Let's see sentence number two. You could, okay, you, subject, could, talk, verb, talk to, your supervisor or the manager. You could talk to your supervisor or your manager. How do you say this in Spanish?
Tú podrías hablar con tu supervisor o el manager.
O el manager, el gerente, right? Good. Ajá, tú podrías hablar con el supervisor o con el gerente, right? Con el gerente. Yes. Let's see the next example. She, okay. She, subject, okay. Could, explain verb, and the complement, her situation, okay? She could explain her situation, okay? How do you say this in Spanish?
Ella podría explicar su situación.
She could explain her situation. And finally, we, subject, could take the verb and the company's transportation, the complement, okay? We could take the company's transportation. We could take the company's transportation. How do you say this in Spanish?
Nosotros podríamos tomar el transporte de la compañía.
Yes, that's right. So in this case, what we are talking about in this topic is that we use could, that we use could, okay? We use could for possibility or to express possibility, okay? Yeah, so whenever you want to express possibility, you can use could, okay? So do you have any question about this? It's easy, right?
Yeah.
Just remember, maybe some things to remember. The verb is in the base form. You don't have to say to, right? She could to explain. No, that's incorrect. Or she could to take. No, that's incorrect, okay? Or she could, you could to request. No, that's incorrect. So it's not possible to use to after could, okay? Not possible. You only say she could explain, she could take, we could talk, we could visit, we could suggest, for example, yeah? Very good. Now, okay, hold on a second. Hold on a second. Now, applying the explanation, okay? You can go to page number 42. You can go to page number 42. Listen, here you have some situations, okay? So situation number one is you don't have a car, okay? What possibility could you give? You don't have a car. What can be a possibility for that?
You could buy one.
Someone of your family is sick. Number two. Someone of your family is sick. What can be a possibility?
You could go to the doctor.
You can go to the doctor with your family. Member, with that family member. Very good. You could take that family member to the doctor, maybe. I could go to the doctor with her or him. Yes. You need to request a legal document, okay? You feel tired and sick, and then you write one problem and you write the possibility, okay? So please, in this moment, you need to write possibilities for the five problems, okay? Number five, create the problem, okay? En el número cinco, ustedes crean el problema. In number five, you create the problem, okay? So this is on page number, what? This 41. Is on page number
42.
42. 42. 42. 42. Okay, so basically, I want you to go in groups of three, okay? In groups of three, try to write possibilities for the problems, okay? Possibilities for the problems. Okay, so let's go to work in groups of three. Ready?
Yes.
Okay. Let's go. Page 42.
Teacher, I don't have a question. Someone of your family is sick.
Esta yo la había pensado. No sé si se puede, pero podría ser someone of your family could sick.
Could sick.
Teacher, if possible, please.
Okay, the possibility could be someone of your family is sick is the problem, right? Yeah? So what is the possibility or the solution for that?
La solución.
Yes.
Could go to the hospital.
Could you
go to the hospital?
You say you, but the, listen to the problem. The problem is someone of your family someone is sick. It's not family. You, it's someone of the family, okay?
Okay. Podría ser someone of your family.
The idea is that you use could, okay? The idea is that you use could to solve the problem, okay? So maybe you can say he or she could. The person who is sick.
Someone of your family could go to the hospital?
Mm-hmm. Kind of, okay. Maybe, but you're getting to the point. Maybe you can say, you can say someone of your family could take the sick person to the hospital. Okay? Or you can say, he or she could go to the hospital, the person who is sick, right? He or she could go to the hospital, okay? That could be the solution. Okay. Él o ella podría ir al hospital. Yeah. Okay?
Okay.
He or she could...
Could go to the hospital.
Go to the hospital.
Or could go to the doctor. I don't know.
Okay. Vaya, la 3 dice, you need to request a legal document. Podría ser... Would you request a legal department?
Remember, Sulma, that is not a question that you are making. So you say you could, okay? Not could you. You say you could, okay? Or he could or she could, okay?
Okay. Entonces podría ser you could.
Yeah.
You could to request.
No. Remember, you don't have to say to. I said it, okay? You could request.
You could request.
Yes, you could request a document.
A legal document.
To legal department.
Okay, better.
Visit
a hospital.
Hospital.
Vaya, ahora. You feel tired. You feel sick.
Cool.
¿Te sientes cansado?
Cool. You call request. A legal
document.
Tired, creo que es cansado.
Tired,
y sick, es enfermo.
Sick, enfermo.
Entonces aquí podríamos poner you
could feel. Feel.
Yo le pondría you could, no sé si se puede, you could take a vacation.
Yeah. O permiso.
O take off. Creo que podría ser otra opción. You could take a day off.
Or you could go to the medical.
O le puede poner you could get in.
Porque está enfermo.
Vacation days.
Tired. Yeah.
Va, entonces, ¿cómo le dejamos? You could.
You could. Take a vacation.
Take a vacation.
Take a long vacation. Take a long vacation.
Take a long vacation. Vaya. Vaya. La número 5. ¿Cuál podríamos poner?
There you need to create the problem, okay? Here in this part, you need to create the problem.
Aquí lo vamos a inventar.
Podría ser.
Could be. Could be. Podría ser. Could be.
Could be.
Could be.
Could be. You need money?
You could request a legal document.
You could
request.
And you know. Request. Document. This. It's okay. It's okay.
Sí, ahí leo yo que dice, tú podrías necesitar solicitar un documento legal.
Legal. Okay.
Remember that you are thinking about solutions, okay, to the problems, because these are problems, okay, you have. So you need to write a solution to that problem, okay? And I feel in number three, I feel that's not like exactly a solution, right? What can be a solution if you need to request a legal document? What can be a solution for that, or what could be a solution for that? What do you think? I mean, what I mean is that the thing here is that you have problems, right? You have possible problems, okay? And you need to write solutions for these problems, or using could, of course, okay? Because if you say, for example, you need to request a legal document, necesita solicitar un documento legal. What can be the solution? You could go with a lawyer, for example. You could go with a lawyer. Okay, that's a solution, I feel, okay? Podrías ir con un abogado. You could go with a lawyer, for example, okay? So that's a solution, yeah?
Okay.
Now you get it? Ahora sí, yes, más o menos. Okay, okay. So in number two, I feel you need to change the solution too.
Sí, yes. Necesitar un abogado, ¿no?
Go. I said you could go. You could go with a lawyer. Mm-hmm. Or to a lawyer. with a lawyer. W before Y. Hello, uh-huh. And then Y. After W, you write Y.
No, what are you saying?
After W, Y, okay? La Y después de la W. Mm-hmm. Lawyer. Yeah.
In this case, you could go to the doctor.
Exactly.
Or but not you. The doctor.
Exactly. That's better because mm-hmm. remember, it's not you. It's someone in your family, okay? Who is sick.
Okay.
Yeah.
Someone in your family is sick. So, yeah, they are going to the doctor.
I could take a day off. I could sleep okay. every day.
For
una semana.
For one week.
Me.
Okay, yes. Me too.
Me.
I could rest.
Uh-huh.
All week.
I could rest all the week.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, and number five.
I name it.
Number five, I have a
toothache. Toothache. I have a
toothache. I could go to the dentist, or I could take some analgesic for the pain. Okay.
How do you say alcaldía in English?
City yes.
City hall.
City Hall.
City Hall.
Yeah.
City Hall.
Okay, City Hall.
Uh-huh. City Hall.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. City Hall.
So did you finish?
Yes. Yes.
Okay, let's go back to the main session then.
Thank you.
City Hall.
Beautiful. To say it. Thank you.
Okay, let's wait for the rest of your classmates. So did you finish? Yeah.
Yes, teacher.
Okay, perfect.
Yes, teacher.
Okay, perfect. So let's wait for the others. I guess they haven't finished. I think the others have not finished. They're coming back. Okay, I guess everybody came back. Now listen, the idea in this activity was, right, basically what you needed was some solutions, okay, for the possible problems or some possibilities or solutions, right, for the problems, okay? For example, I was giving some examples and the idea was to use could, okay? The idea was to use could. Imagine number one, you don't have a car. Ah, what could be a possibility? So a possibility could be you could buy one. You could buy one car or a car, okay? Number two, someone of your family is sick. So a possibility can be he or she could go to the doctor, for example. He or she could go to the doctor. Number three, you need to request a legal document. You need a legal document. So what can be a possibility? Oh, I could go to with a lawyer, for example, I don't know. Or I could go to the law department, okay? Yeah, you feel tired. You should take, or you could, sorry, you could take a long vacation, you can say, all right? Very good. So basically here, you have different solutions, okay? I know your solutions will vary. Good, now listen. Using the solutions you have, everybody took notes, right? Todos tomaron notas de las soluciones. Everybody took notes.
Yes, teacher.
Yes.
Yeah, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
All right. All right. Now listen. Using the possibilities or the solutions you have, you are going to practice a conversation using that vocabulary. Okay? You are going to practice a conversation using this vocabulary or the solutions here. How? All right. So you will work in pairs. Okay? So you will choose one situation from this exercise and create a conversation, okay? And the conversation can be similar to the conversation we practice here, okay? The conversation can be similar to the conversation we practice here, okay? So imagine you go in pairs and you say, good morning. For example, good morning, Rosa, how are you doing today? And Rosa tells me, hello, Bernardo, I am okay, all right? Or I am a little bad, maybe you can say. And I say, oh, what's wrong? What's wrong, Rosa? Well, and Rosa explained the situation, okay? Well, I need to get a legal document, okay? And I have to work, for example, I don't know, okay? And I have to work. You say, I say, I am sorry to hear that. You could ask for permission, I say. Ah, oh, you're right, Rosa can tell me, right? Because it's in pairs, okay? You're right, Rosa can tell me. I could go to human resources or with a lawyer, I don't know, and request something, yeah? So the idea is that you practice the conversation using one of the problems from this part, okay? So you need to create a conversation in pairs and then you present to the class. Any question? Using one of these problems, okay? So you can restructure the conversation. Pueden reestructurar la conversación si quieren. You can restructure the conversation if you want, okay? Any question?
No.
Everything is clear?
Yes.
Yes, okay, so let's go to work then. I will give you 15 minutes for this, okay? 15 minutes for this. Okay, let's go to practice. You need to go to the group, Maria. Maria, you need to go to the group.
No, hello, Gary. I little bad.
Really?
Really? What's wrong? What's wrong? Hmm?
Really? What's wrong?
Well, I need money.
All the world.
Who doesn't?
I need one million.
One million.
What?
Okay. Yes. Vaya. Copiamos. Good more. Good morning. Good evening. Dejemos mejor. Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening, Ali.
Good evening, how are you today? How are you doing today?
How are you doing
today? Me. Hello, Darwin. I'm a little bad. Darwin, really?
Dejémoslo así, ¿cómo está?
Así lo dejamos.
Sí.
Good morning, Alex. I how are you going today?
Hello, Ham. Hello, Felia. I am okay, but Angela is not.
I was wrong, Betty.
Ahora.
Well, my mother is sick in my daughter's. Daughter? Teacher, ¿cómo se pronuncia? Hija.
Daughter.
Daughter.
My daughter.
Daughter. My daughter. My daughter. ¿Cómo podría decir que está enferma? Ah, no. Si mi mamá está enferma.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, my mother is sick and my sister can go see her tomorrow.
I'm sorry, I do have, I just you pull. I ask for permission.
No, ahí es donde tenemos que cambiarla, porque como ella está enferma, ajá, según lo que respondimos en las oraciones que creamos, en el ejercicio anterior, ajá, llevarla al doctor o algo.
Podríamos poner.
You pull, ir al hospital.
Uh-huh. And you could get for hospital.
I'm sorry, I go to hospital.
Go to the doctor?
Yeah.
For example? Uh-huh. Go to the doctor?
Yes, it's correct.
I could go to the doctor.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
She's right. And you could go on the hospital provider or general?
General, no. It's complicated.
Yeah.
You say private hospital or public hospital? Private or public hospital, okay?
Private
or public? Private hospital or public hospital?
Hospital.
Teacher, en la conversación, aquí está Julie dos veces participa, ahí, seguido.
No, there is an error. On the second Julie, could I mention, it's Betty, okay? There is an error. There is an error.
Okay, Angel, next.
Okay. Could I mention the reason for the permission? For the permission,
and your sister?
Um,
for the pay?
Could I mention the reason for the permission at for personal?
Yes, Angela.
No, absolutely, absolutely.
Absolutely, digo eso también.
Ya. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Vaya, yes, absolutely. Vaya, ya tenemos la idea. Ahora pero, tratemos de hacerlo lo mejor que podamos. Pero, comience, comience, Ofelia.
Good morning, Elise. How are you going today?
Hello, Ofelia. I am okay, but Angela is not.
Really, I was wrong, Betty.
Angela.
Angela.
Well, my mother is sick and my sister can go see you her tomorrow.
Ahí sería.
Yes, of course. Good, ¿cómo fue? Good, you?
Could you share me the contact by WhatsApp, please?
Could you share me the contact by WhatsApp? By WhatsApp. Te diría, sí, por supuesto. Yes, of course. Yes. Of course.
Okay. What about the permission? Integrate in the conversation.
What?
Okay, repeat the conversation.
Ah, bye. Good. Voy. Estoy agregando los nombres. Bye.
But in this case, you are my boss.
Yes.
You are co-worker. You are co-worker.
Yes. Good morning, Rafa. How are you doing today?
Hello, Michelle. I am okay, but I need to request a legal document for tomorrow.
Really? Well, you could go to the lawyer.
Okay, do you know any lawyer?
Yes, of course. I will send you the information of my lawyer.
Could you share me the contact by WhatsApp, please?
Yes.
Go to the lawyer. Go to
right now, I need go to go to
teacher. Quiero escribir. Necesito ir donde un abogado.
You can say maybe you don't have to say necesito ir. Maybe Maybe you can say I could. Yo podría ir, or in this moment you are mentioning the problem.
But, es que,
I want to see the context. Yeah.
Okay. Le leemos lo que tenemos, Osun.
Yes, please.
Está bien, está bien. Hello, good. Todo. Yeah. Hello, good morning, Yancy. How are you doing today?
Hello, Osun. I feel tired.
Really? What is wrong?
Yes. No, I am sorry to hear that.
Ah, sí, mi tío maestro tiene razón. I am sorry to hear that. You call rest tomorrow.
Oh, I would like to, but I have to work early. And how are you doing today?
I am fine. I am fine. Thank you.
Teacher, esa segunda parte donde yo le regreso la pregunta de cómo está Osmin, él me respondería, yo estoy bien. Ahora mismo necesito ir donde un abogado.
I see. All right.
La idea es decirle después, ¿podrías ir al que está aquí en la plaza más cercana?
No. Make it simple, okay? Use the problem that you solved, okay? In the problem you had, I need to request a legal document. So you can say that, okay? Uh-huh. I need to request a legal document. And then you say, you could go to a lawyer. You say, Jancy, okay? So Osmin can say, I need to request a legal document. Necesito solicitar un documento legal. And then you give the possibility, right, for the solution. You could go with a lawyer, okay?
Okay.
Hmm? Yeah, okay. You can use the information, that information.
Okay.
Entonces sería, I need to request a legal document.
Uh-huh. You call visit a lawyer.
Okay, como me dijo, perdone, yo, you.
Shh, ahí viene, teacher.
Bye, yo creo que así la podemos dejar.
Yes, hoy sí.
Azalia. Bye. You're so mean.
Here, teacher.
You're so mean. What is that? You're so mean. What is that, Mayra?
No.
You are so mean. Because you said, I've been a teacher, I've been a teacher. So I said, you are so mean. What is that? Any idea?
No.
It's like, eres muy mala, pero no mala de una mala manera, right? Eres muy mala, pero, like, que le gusta bromear.
No, tengo buen pensamiento.
That's why I make the difference, okay? El significado en sí de esa frase es, eres mala, pero, o sea, de bromas, de hacer bromas. No es algo malo, okay? So you can see you're so mean.
Ay, no. Por rato me sale esto. I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. Don't worry. I'm just kidding, okay?
Thank you, teacher.
Solo quiero que aprenda una frase. I just want you to learn a phrase, okay?
Okay.
Thank you,
you're so mean. You're so mean.
You're so mean.
Mean. Are you ready?
Okay.
Yes, teacher.
Yes, you practiced? Did you practice? Yes?
Moment.
A little.
Moment, please. One minute. Creo que sí se dice.
One minute.
One moment.
Okay, 1 minute.
moment.
Okay. You can practice again in the meantime, okay? I will just let me visit the group and then we go out, okay? So you can practice again. Okay.
Okay. Bye. Entonces, si gusta, voy a iniciar. Hasta ahí.
Yes.
Good morning.
You could go to the HR department and request a form.
Would I mention the reason for the permission?
Yes, absolutely. Again, change roles.
Ready. Ready.
Yes.
Yes, ready.
Okay. Okay, that's perfect.
This is the conversation.
Okay, you maximize
it. Do you see my screen?
Yes, I see, but can you maximize it a little bit? Can you zoom it in? Un poquito de zoom.
Okay.
A little more, please.
Yes.
Yeah, enough. I am not okay, really, what's wrong? Well, I need a rental contract. Okay, you could go with a lawyer. You're right. I could ask to the legal department and request advisory. Uh-huh. To the legal department and request advisory. Yes, absolutely. Yeah, it's okay. Short and simple, but great. Short and simple, yes, but awesome. But it's very good. It's very clear. Okay.
Okay. Thank you, teacher.
All right. So did you practice?
Yes, I practiced.
Okay, yes, that's perfect.
Practice again too?
Yeah, if you want. It's okay. In the meantime.
Okay.
Okay.
Good morning, Suma. How are you? How are you doing today?
Hello, Miguel. I am not okay.
What's wrong?
Well, I need a rental contract.
You could go with the lawyer.
You're right. I could ask to the legal department and request advisory.
Yes, absolutely.
Woohoo. Finish. Bye, Miguel.
Bye, bye. Thank you so much.
Okay, let's wait for the others. I think they are still making the conversation, so let's wait for them.
Teacher.
Yep.
Piense que nosotros escribimos esta frase, pero me cuesta pronunciarlo.
Can you say it? Say it.
I hope you can achieve it.
Achieve.
Pero, ajá, cuando deseamos lograrlo, le ponemos achieve y con un it. ¿Verdad?
Yeah.
Achieve. Entonces, achieve no sé cómo.
Achieve,
achieve it.
Ajá, uh-huh. I hope achieve. You can achieve it.
Achieve it.
Yes.
Okay. I hope you can achieve it and rest.
Yeah. It's okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Achieve it.
Achieve it and rest. Yeah, it's okay. No problem. Okay, everybody. So did everyone finish? Yes.
Yes. Yes, yes, teacher.
All right.
Yes, teacher.
All right. Unfortunately, today we don't have time to present, okay? But tomorrow you will present, okay? For sure. For sure, tomorrow you will present. And the first activity for tomorrow is presenting the conversation, okay? The first activity for tomorrow is presenting the conversation. And your classmates need you to be early, to be connected early, okay? Your classmates okay. need you to be connected early. So okay, please, sure. okay, please don't disappoint your classmates, okay? You're not going to disappoint me. You are going to disappoint your classmates, okay? So please get connected early, all right? So you perform the conversation with your classmate, okay? So let me pass the attendance quickly. Ada Patricia?
Present.
Good. Adriana?
Present.
Ana Michelle?
Present.
Azalia Melanie?
Present, teacher.
Good. No se me vayan todavía, okay? Quiero darles una indicación, please. Okay, so please don't
Good
go.
Good night, teacher.
Good night. Not yet. Not yet. Azalia Melanie said good night, right? Yeah. So good night. Darwin.
Present, teacher.
Flor.
Good night.
Present.
Gloria.
Here.
Carla.
Present.
Margarita.
Present.
María.
Present.
Very good. Mayra.
Present.
Okay, Nelson.
Present.
Ofelia.
Here, teacher.
Osmin.
Present, teacher.
Rafael. Rafael.
Present, present.
Okay, okay. Rosa.
Present.
Okay, Sandra.
Present, teacher.
Yancy.
Present.
Zulma.
Here.
And Miguel.
Me, teacher.
Present, teacher.
Who didn't I mention? ¿A quién no mencioné? Who didn't I mention?
Me.
Ángela, I'm sorry, Ángela. I'm sorry. But I put the attendance here, Ángela. Don't worry, okay? Good. Okay, thank you very much. I'm sorry. Okay, good. Just before you go. Well, the one-on-one session today is for whom? Michelle, right?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, so listen, just before you go. Solo antes de que se vayan. El día de ayer tomé un espacio para hacer un recordatorio acerca de la fecha de inscripción para el siguiente módulo. Les decía que tenemos hasta el lunes, esto es por los que no estuvieron conectados, ¿ok? Tenemos hasta el viernes para presentar documentos, ¿ok? Para el siguiente módulo. Recursos humanos,
¿lunes
¿verdad?
O viernes?
Nosotros estar pendientes. Hold on, esperen un momento. Viernes. Y si en caso no aparece, no les sale lo de la planilla que les están pidiendo, hasta lunes máximo, ¿ok? Fecha máxima, ¿ok? Pero si sale antes, obviamente van a poder hacerlo antes, ¿verdad? Por supuesto. El lunes es para los que no les salga lo de la planilla, ¿ok? Para que estemos pendientes. Y lo de la encuesta de satisfacción es el día viernes. El día viernes todos deben estar conectados, sin excepción, ¿ok? Toda la clase. Tenemos la encuesta de satisfacción y es un requisito, ¿ok? Es un requisito para poder pasar el módulo, ¿ok?
Yes, teacher.
¿Sí? ¿Alguien iba a decir algo? Teacher. ¿Margarita?
Sí, teacher. Pregunto acerca de los diplomas.
Ah, eso, ahorita se me estaba. Ok. ¿Me hacen un favor? Es que a veces yo con tantas cosas se me olvida. Pero me hacen un favor, me escriben un mensajito. ¿Alguien me recuerda? Teacher, por favor, pregunte acerca de los diplomas. Un mensaje personal para yo hacer la consulta. El día de mañana, ¿ok? Ahí durante el día, por favor. Everybody, que todos que lo hagan. Para recibir 21 mensajes. Ok, muy bien.
O no recibe ninguno.
O no recibo ninguno. Bien, entonces, bueno, respecto a la encuesta de satisfacción, obviamente durante la semana les va a caer el mensajito. No completen la encuesta de satisfacción. La encuesta de satisfacción la completan conmigo.
El viernes.
¿Okay? El viernes. Así que no se me adelanten, por favor. ¿Ok?
Sí, el viernes es último día.
Sí, viernes terminamos módulo. Rápido, ¿verdad?
Ah. Rápido.
Super rápido, super fast, okay? Muy bien, okay, so thank you very much everybody for connecting. Remember, you are presenting the conversation tomorrow early,
okay.
early. All right, very good. So, thank you very much. Good night.
See you tomorrow.
Goodbye. See you tomorrow.
Bye, teacher.
Bye. Bye.
Good night.
Good night. Good night.
Good dreams.
Now you can say good night.
Bye, everybody.
Bye bye.
Good night. Today, I see. Tomorrow. Good night.
Okay, Michelle, just let's wait for, yeah, he left, Osmin left. Okay, Michelle, so this space is for you.
Vaya. Creo que el tema que no me quedó muy claro fue el de presente perfecto.
Present perfect, okay.
Yes, present perfect.
Okay, so do you want me to explain all the topic again? The structure, everything? ¿Quieres que te explique todo de nuevo? ¿O hay alguna parte en específico? ¿La estructura?
Sí, más que todo con las terceras personas y quisiera saber más en cuanto a oraciones negativas.
Ah, okay, sí, porque solo vimos positivo. Okay, muy bien.
Ajá.
Sí, básicamente lo primero que hay que saber es que el presente perfecto es para hablar acerca de acciones que empezaron en el pasado. ¿Ok? Empiezan en el pasado. Uh-huh. Y continúan en el presente posiblemente. ¿Ok? Y seguramente continuarán. Okay. Seguramente, continúan en el presente y posiblemente continuarán en el futuro. Por ejemplo, si yo digo en el futuro. Uh-huh. Ah, es como que está en una línea de tiempo desde pasado, presente y posiblemente hasta futuro. ¿Ok? Imagínate que yo digo, I have checked my email. Yo he revisado mi correo. La acción empezó en el pasado, ¿verdad? I have checked my email. Uh-huh. Posiblemente lo voy a revisar otra vez, ¿ok? Y lo voy a seguir revisando. Okay. So it's like in the three tenses, ¿ok? Está como en una línea en los tres tiempos. Past, present, and future, ¿ok? Muy bien. Ahora, hablemos de la estructura. Let's speak about the structure, ¿ok? Vaya, mira.
Okay.
Dame un segundo. Déjame maximizar aquí. Muy bien. Vea, si hablamos de la estructura, primero tenemos, en una oración positiva, primero tenemos el subject, ¿ok?
Uh-huh.
Luego tenemos el have o el has. Depende si estamos usando tercera persona o si estamos usando I, you, we, they, o plurales, ¿ok? Luego tenemos el verbo, pero aquí en este caso el verbo ya no va a ir en su forma base ni en su forma pasado. Va a ir en su forma que llamamos past participle, ¿ok? Que es una forma diferente al pasado y al presente, por supuesto, ¿ok? Para los verbos irregulares tal vez es un tanto más complicado porque a veces cambian su forma completamente en presente, en pasado y en pasado participio. Y eso debemos uh-huh. memorizarlos, ¿ok? Y aquí podemos tener un complemento como en cualquier oración en inglés, ¿ok? Un complement. Good.
Okay.
Ahora bien, tomando esto en cuenta, veamos algunos ejemplos. Let's check some examples. Okay, let me change the color. So, yo podría decir, por ejemplo, en el sujeto, podría decir I, okay? It's a subject. I have, for example, I have, what can I say? Eaten. I will say eaten, okay? Que es el pasado participio de comer. I have eaten two hamburgers, for example. Two tacos, all right? I have eaten two tacos. Mm-hmm. Me he comido dos tacos. Yes? Probablemente estoy comiendo en ese momento y me voy a comer otro más, ¿ok? Lo que yo te decía, empieza en el pasado, continúa en el presente y probablemente seguirá en el futuro, ¿ok? That depends on me. Yeah? Mm-hmm. That depends on me. Ahora bien, okay. How do I make this negative? ¿Cómo paso esta oración en negativo? Podría decir fácilmente, voy a usar la forma corta en este caso. I haven't. ¿Ok? La forma corta o podría decir uh-huh. I have not. Si yo quiero, I have not. Y luego lo mismo, eaten two tacos. I haven't eaten two tacos. Yo no me he comido dos tacos. El verbo have y el has, aquí el sentido o el significado es el verbo haber. Ya no es el verbo tener. Porque es un verbo auxiliar uh-huh. aquí. ¿Ok? Ya significa haber, no tener. Yo he, tú has, él ha. ¿Ok? So, para la tercera persona que sería he, it sería la tercera persona, sí, lo que tú dices. Voy a usar el has, ¿ok? He has. Okay. So I could say, for example, un verbo en pasado participio podría ser send. I will say sent. Sent. El pasado participio de send, de enviar, es sent. So I can say, he has sent, mm-hmm. él ha enviado, he has sent the information, for example, the info, all right? He has sent the information. He has sent the information, okay? Él ha enviado la información. He has sent the information. También digo she has sent the information. Or it has sent. En este caso, it es para una cosa, no puedo decir que ha enviado la información, right? Okay? The same, if I want to make it negative, si quiero hacerlo negativo, hago lo mismo. Voy a decir, hasn't o has not, okay?
Okay.
Yes?
O sea, de que en negativo, el verbo siempre se mantiene, ¿verdad? Como en pasado participio.
Sí, no cambia.
Ah, okay.
Y en pregunta
incluso
tampoco.
Incluso en cambia. La pregunta.
Ajá, eso vamos a la pregunta. En la pregunta okay. es facilito. En la pregunta lo que hago es con el have y el has, los pongo antes del sujeto en la pregunta. ¿Eso es todo? Ok, hold on a second.
Ah, ok.
Ajá, los pongo
acá.
Sí,
yo tenía la duda. Ajá.
Ajá.
Sí, yo tenía la duda por si el verbo cambiaba, ya sea en negativo o en pregunta.
No,
pero
no, no.
Sí, se mantiene.
No, lo que cambia es nada más el verbo auxiliar, ¿ok? Para have y has, que, para el, que uso el he, she, it, uso el has. Y para los demás pronombres, en plural, uso el have. Y la primera persona es singular, ¿ok? Eso es básicamente lo que cambia, pero okay, el verbo en pasado participio, ese va lo mismo en presente perfecto, ¿ok? Ese no cambia. That doesn't change.
Ok, y en presente perfecto, el auxiliar siempre va a ser have o has.
Exactamente. Yes, always.
Ah, ok. Ok, ah, pues sí, esa es la duda que tenía nada más.
Ah, ok, perfect. So, only that, solo eso.
¿Sí?
Ok.
Eso debe ser la duda.
Ok, thank you then, Michelle, for connecting. Ok, thank you for staying. Ok,
yes.
Okay, bye, well, good night.
Good night, teacher.
See you tomorrow.
Yes.
Okay, bye.